focus. But about that day or hour, no one knows. Neither the angels in heaven, nor the Son, but only the Father. Jesus begins his eschatological discourse by revealing the impending destruction of the temple. The disciples anxiously seek to know the timeline. Jesus does not answer. He has more to say on the last things. He gives the entire spectrum of dire events, all as a prelude to his second coming and the inevitability of God's final judgment. Then, sensing their growing anxiety, he answers their query by stating that God alone knows the timing of these events. He also counsels them that it is better to prepare themselves for this by keeping alert and leading lives of patient endurance than to agonize over the timing of the last judgment. To their credit, Jesus' disciples weathered the storms of disquiet, doubt and despair as his passion and death unfolded. Then, emboldened by the resurrection and empowered by the Holy Spirit, they set about fulfilling their great commission in diverse ways. Some did it by faithfully recording everything Jesus said and did for our edification and preparedness. We have our task cut out. We need only to choose wisely. And Jesus' words transcend time. Fruit. I will order my life on the eternal wisdom of the Word of God and trust His divine judgment.